Hi, welcome to GeeklyEDU Biology. In this video, we're going to be discussing the endosymbiotic theory, which is the theory of how eukaryotic cells formed. So all life originally came from a single common ancestor and then evolved into different forms. So we have bacteria and archaea, which are prokaryotes because they lack nuclei in their cells. And then we also have eukaryotes, which do have proper nuclei. And so these are things such as mammals and birds and humans. And when we're thinking about how eukaryotes evolved, we have to look at what happened here throughout history. Where did we go from prokaryotes to eukaryotes? So we believe that prokaryotic cells existed before eukaryotic cells because their fossils date further back in time and their structures are just more primitive than eukaryotic cells. But how did these prokaryotic cells evolve into the eukaryotic cells that exist today? And the endosymbiotic theory is basically to explain how this happened. And looking at this word endosymbiotic, it's quite a big word, but we can break it down. So endo means in, sym means together, and biotic means living. So living together inside, basically. So what this theory really means is that one organism lives within another in a symbiotic relationship. And this idea was first published by the researcher Lynn Margulis in her 1967 paper on the origin of eukaryotic cells. Honing in a little bit more on the endosymbiotic theory itself, so this theory suggests that early prokaryotic cells were either joined or eaten by other cells. And so we can imagine one prokaryotic cell eating another type. But unlike that figure that was just shown there, instead of breaking down the prokaryotic cell that the other cell just ate, it rather kept that prokaryotic cell within its cell membrane and just let it live there. So we think that this symbiotic relationship was first formed with prokaryotic cells either resembling mitochondria or chloroplasts, because these are the organelles in a cell that provide energy. So these prokaryotic cells were eaten but then kept around because they could give that cell more energy. And then these prokaryotic cells that were the mitochondria or chloroplasts that were originally eaten or joined in the other prokaryotic cells, they eventually, after living in this host cell, they decided that, or evolved to where they lost the unnecessary parts of their original prokaryotic cell form, such as their cell wall and some of their DNA, because it was no longer needed now that it was living in this host cell. And so this is just a theory still, and so we don't know this for sure, but there's a lot of evidence supporting this endosymbiotic theory. And this includes the following: of mitochondria and chloroplasts have their own cell membranes and are really the only organelles in our cells that do have these membranes, such as the prokaryotic cells originally did as well. These organelles also have their own circular DNA, such as the prokaryotic cells that exist today also have their own circular DNA. And then these organelles have their own ribosomes, and the subunits of these ribosomes are pretty similar to prokaryotic cells. And then they also have similar sizes to some prokaryotic cells of today, and also mitochondria and chloroplasts have been shown to divide by what's called binary fission, which is the way that prokaryotic cells will divide. That's all we have on the endosymbiotic theory in today's video. And if you want to learn more about the origin of life or other biological concepts, please subscribe here for more.